Hi everyone, it's Ileane from basicblogtips.com. Today I want to introduce you to an extension for Chrome that will let you save time by reading blog posts to you so you don't have to read them yourself. This also means that you can listen to them on your phone when you're away from your computer. And this extension is called SoundGecko. And here it is over in the Chrome store. So it's SoundGecko, that's GECKO. After you've installed the extension, you'll want to go over to the website and register and set up your account. This is where you'll set what your voice preferences are. And this is just the type of voice that you want the article to be read back to you in, and you can play around with all those different voices and see which one suits your personality. And we'll also take a look at the cloud drive integration. I'm using Google Drive, but you can also use Dropbox or SkyDrive. First, I'll demonstrate Google Drive. Now here the file has been saved over into my Google Drive. I have the file checked off, and I'm going to come up here to where it says More. In this case, I'm going to open the file with Drive Tunes.
7 Reasons You Should Not Start a Podcast by Ryan Henley. Podcasting is not for everyone. Despite the many experts, gurus, rocksters, and ninjas within the content marketing space moving their voice to the podcast format, podcasting will not work for everyone.
And if you're looking for those applications to add onto Google Drive, you would just go here where it says More and connect more apps. And actually, this is a great area for you to explore to see all of the apps that you can connect with Google Drive. And here's that one we were just using. It's called Drive Tunes. Now here's the alternate way that we can listen to that article with SoundGecko. We will go over to our email because SoundGecko will automatically email the article to us. Now it will automatically open a browser. SoundGecko will be at the top of the page and we'll see the player. It actually automatically starts playing. I just put it on pause. And here's your volume control, and you can also download that MP3.
It's 7 Reasons You Should Not Start a Podcast by Ryan Henley.
Now, if you don't want to get those emails, you just want to go right over to Google Drive and read it, or actually listen to it, then just go into your settings page on the website and go to your notification settings and turn that off so you can control all of these things. The other option you have here is that you can get an email digest. You can get that once or twice a day, and you can set it for any time zone and any time of day that you want to receive that. And then that way you will always have all the articles that you sent over to SoundGecko, and then you can play them at your leisure. Now, I heard about this tool over on the social media marketing podcast with Mike Stelzner, so I wanted to take a minute to give him a shout out. Now, here's another thing you can do. They have a pro version of SoundGecko, and you can get PDF documents, additional voices, and increase of your word count limit, and that's for $2.95 a month. But you don't have to pay for that if you don't want to, because they also have a refer a friend program. So you can refer your friends on Facebook, on Twitter, and if they sign up, and here's your link. So if other people sign up, you get credit for that, and then you can use that credit to go ahead. Because I think really the PDF, you know, all those ebooks that we get all the time, and you really don't have time to read half of them. But if you have this option to get SoundGecko to read PDF documents to you, now that can really save time. You can also connect SoundGecko to your favorite podcasting app. In this case, I'm going to show you how to use it for iTunes on my PC. So I will click that, get my podcasting feed, and then I'll click on the iTunes, and of course it'll ask me to launch the application. And here you'll see right up at the top, here's that post, 7 Reasons You Should Not Start a Podcast. But what'll happen is if I go over to where all of my podcasts are located on iTunes, on my PC, let me scroll down, and you'll see in the list here now I have SoundGecko. I have a lot of podcasts, don't I? You know I'm a podcaster. I love it. Anyway, here we go. Here's SoundGecko. So now all the articles that I've ever sent to SoundGecko are here for me. If I want to download them, I can. And that really will help me for my commute because I actually burn CDs so I can listen to my podcasts on my commute. And now I can add these SoundGecko clips and I can really listen to my ebooks as I'm commuting back and forth to work. Here's a great example over on my resources page. I have an ebook for people to download. Now I'm going to send that over to SoundGecko. Now let's pop over to iTunes.
Form for you to think outside of the box. Experiment with it, and if you don't like the results, move on to the next. Right now.
Well, there's just no telling how many ebooks I'm going to get a chance to read now. That is really cool. I want you guys to check out SoundGecko. I think it's going to save you a lot of time. And not that I don't want you to listen to my podcast, but this is something that will really come in as a handy tool when you're on the go and when you just don't feel like reading. Maybe you just want to rest your eyes. That happens to me quite a bit. So thanks so much for joining me. And while you're over here on YouTube, be sure to subscribe to my channel. And visit me on basicblogtips.com. I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.